Music affects my day-to-day life because I'm literally thinking about it constantly or listening to it constantly. While whether it's like while I'm traveling from off campus to class or going back home or in between classes, or then I'll go home after doing homework and start strumming the guitar, practicing, trying to get better, and then just writing something. So it's kind of like on a constant loop, just me thinking like, oh, I should like do a cover right now. Oh, I should write something. It's always something that I feel like I need to be doing. My dad has been the greatest like music influence on me in my life, I'd say. Around the same time that I started picking up the guitar on my way to college, he was teaching himself as well and was like taking lessons, and then he eventually met the guys that he would be in a band with in college, and they were signed at some point, and like they did gigs throughout like my life as well, and I'd always end up going to those. I'd say my dad, he had like all kinds of music playing in the living room growing up, and that's like a very distinct memory of mine. He would like be playing all these old CDs and like jazz, like Miles Davis and Amy Winehouse, and then like Latin music because my dad's from Peru, and just like this whole eclectic mix, and I was exposed to like a lot of different kinds of things, and I'd always end up singing along, and I found like a lot of joy in that, so that's eventually how I got into it. Like especially Amy Winehouse, who is like one of my favorite artists of all time now, just because she kind of had, especially with her first album Frank, very stripped down kind of electric guitar, and her voice was always something that captivated me. I found that besides just admiring that album and her previous album, I just find her voice, like her sound, to kind of co-align with how I sing a lot of the time, and I just love like her tone. And my dad was kind of like, he used to say, oh, if you can sing like Amy, like you're good, like you're there already. And I remember just hearing that and thinking that was really cool. And so I like doing her songs, and it's kind of like an homage, or like paying homage to my dad and like our living room dances growing up.
He left no time to regret, kept his lips wet with his same old safe bed. Me and my head high and my tears dry, get on without my guy. Yo, I'm back to what you know, so far removed from all that we went through. And I tread a troubled track. My odds are stacked, and I go back to black. We only said goodbye with words I died 100 times. You go back to her, and I go back to much. It's not enough. You love blow and I love bow. And life is like a pipe, and I'm a tiny penny rolling up the walls inside. We only said goodbye. Love. black, 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 black.
I grew up like a musical theater kid, and that was like the outlet for people that liked to sing. Like there weren't that many like, oh, you are interested in like making music or like singing your own music kind of thing. So I immediately kind of got into musical theater and did that like throughout my whole entire life. But I was always more drawn towards singing like pop artists' music for like auditions or for local gigs and things like that. So when I started like realizing that, and I was like, like I'm more inclined to like perform these types of songs, I like began writing. But I also tried writing in like elementary school about things that I had no idea about, like love and relationships and being heartbroken. But I tried, and then I kept at it, and then here we are. For my song Flight 2402, when I was making like an inspiration playlist for it, I totally thought, with the help of my producer on that song, Noah Leong, I made a playlist for him of like inspiration, and I totally thought that I was crazy and like that those things sounds like wouldn't go together. And I was mixing like SZA and like Amy with like the drum beats, which you can hear kind of in the song, and then in like the bridge or like the slowed down part of the song, you can kind of hear that more like SZA-ish sound where it's like more slowed down R&B. So Flight 2402, lyrically, a lot of people, just because I reference it so much, it's like, oh, it's about your ex, which like it is, but I always say it's like more about me and like my journey from leaving home and coming to the East Coast, which is like why I named it Flight 2402, which was my exact flight number from LA to Boston when I moved for the first time. And it's really just like a transitional piece, like about leaving someone, but in general just leaving like a life that you had behind. But I wasn't really feeling much nostalgia about it. I was like happy to like start fresh, like I needed that. And so Flight 2402 is about looking back and like thinking about it sometimes, like yes, that was a thing, I was with this person, this was my life, but I'm here right now and I'm like much happier this way.
This boy drives an Infiniti. That car has like 200,000 miles on it. I don't know how he still drives it.
Left you on the West Coast. Tears fell down at Terminal 4. You text me not to cry, but this is my goodbye. Held you close last night. Didn't feel quite right. Board my flight and forget. I know you're thinking more than me, how things could be different. I listened, but I can't bring myself to that point. I block you out, it's temporary, you're creeping on me. Round again. and again. I don't wanna remember, but I can't forget you, 'cause it took so long to leave you without an excuse. But I packed up and I'm gone. I regret none of it. It doesn't hurt me anymore to walk out the door and wonder if you're nearby. These tears have dried. Yeah. The streets I walk along, I've never felt the soles of your shoes, and I'm used to it now. I know you're thinking more than me, how things could be different. I listened, but I can't bring myself to that point. I block you out, it's temporary, you're creeping on me round again.
In terms of me as an artist, everything that I write about is pretty much real and like something that happened to me. And I like am more inclined to write about it when I'm struggling with it. And then by the time that it's kind of put out for a minute or that I've been working on it for a while, I feel better about it. And so it's just like very honest stuff that I just decide to write about almost to make myself feel better. And that's how it comes about.